assets, opportunities even, that you may lose.
You must ask yourself if you love the people, because the only thing that can bind you to the people you serve is love. Ambition is not enough.
I have discovered the power of kindness, and that has made me a radical optimist. That's why I stay away from politics and from religion.
Countries that take unilateral action or coercive action
actually like Pinoy personally.
It's not a beauty contest who's ahead of who.
Yeah.
Once upon a time, we were all irrelevant. And I sincerely believe that there will come a time we will all return to the dark embrace of irrelevance.
Martin's Man Cave.
Martin's Man Cave is back. This is the 84th episode with the former Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, Vice President Teofisto Guingona, Jr. Vice President, let's talk about your family. Let's start with your wife, Ruth. How did you meet Ruth?
Well, after graduation from my studies at Ateneo, I was taken into a law firm, De Vera and Tomacruz, here at the old Escolta, during one of the lulls. A lady from Gingoog, mestiza, beautiful, was accompanied by her auntie to see me. Well, of course, I asked them to join me for lunch, and I found out that she could sing. She could cook. She could do many things that I valued in life. She was honest, according to that auntie of hers, because she was hailed by her teachers. Of course, since Gingoog was only an hour's drive from Butuan, my vehicle took me to Gingoog. And there, I was reunited with that lady who visited me. And therefore, the beginning of the marital challenge began. I asked her, since you visited me, it was an indication that you were interested in me. And since she did not deny it, I pursued and said, will you? And before I could finish, she said, yes. So that happened. And when that happened, we got married in a span of 2 years. We produced a curly-haired child. We learned how to take care of the first child. Then the second child came. Another 2 years or 3 years later, another boy So it became to be a boyish I think she said, I hope the next one will be a girl. I said, no, boys, all boys. Of course, I was just kidding her. She says, no, we need a girl. And as if Providence heard what she was saying, this girl came.
Let's talk about your children. Tell us about Raul. How would you describe him to us?
Raul is, he was the second son. Mm-hmm. He's very bright, but gifted with a talent for piano. And so therefore he, from the very beginning, he would on the table make it appear that he was playing piano, but actually he became a pianist and he's teaching piano. The first is Tutsi, and he's now a senator. The third is Marie, and she is now a mayor of Gingoog City.
Who are the people that you would like to say thank you, that you owe a debt of gratitude, and you'd like to acknowledge?
I would like to thank Lorenzo Tañada. I would like to thank Chino Rosas. I would like to thank Giocno, Jose Giocno, Salonga, Ramos, and many others of the same, many others that I, but those are samples of people who really help.
Thank you so much for your time, Mr. Vice President Teofisto Guingona Jr. God bless you, sir.
Thank you.
And you just heard the former Vice President himself, Vice President Teofisto Guingona Jr., here inside the 84th episode of Martin's Man Cave on Podcast.ph. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again.